Here we want to calculate the heat of adsorption from a couple measurements of physical adsorption of nitrogen on charcoal. These measurements were made at low coverages of nitrogen, so we make some assumptions to calculate the heat of adsorption. So we have two measurements at different temperatures and pressures. Should point out that we're probably not going to get a very accurate heat of adsorption measurement from just two measurements at such different temperatures. Accuracy of the measurements has to be really quite good. And to get a good measure, we should take measurements at a number of temperatures. But to demonstrate the idea, we'll use these two temperatures. And what we're going to do is assume Langmuir type behavior for adsorption. So this is the fractional coverage, theta is fractional coverage, versus pressure. High enough pressure, this is saturation, namely we've covered the surface with nitrogen. And at lower pressures, some regime, we have a linear behavior. And so the Langmuir isotherm says the fractional coverage is an adsorption equilibrium constant times the pressure over 1 plus that same adsorption equilibrium constant and pressure. We're going to look at the case of low coverage. So we're saying this is approximately equal to K times the pressure. And then we can calculate K at the two conditions. At 190 Kelvin, we don't know the actual fractional coverage, we just know how much it's adsorbed. So how much it's adsorbed, of course, divided by the saturation coverage would give us the fractional coverage. So we're saying it's proportional to the fractional coverage. And so I'm just use alpha as the proportionality constant times 0.92. This is going to be equal to our adsorption equilibrium constant times the pressure. And of course, the same thing at 250 Kelvin. So we can solve for K1, which corresponds to adsorption equilibrium constant at 190 in terms of alpha. And that's just 0.1917 times alpha. K2 is 0.02875 times alpha. Now, K is related to the heat of adsorption by a pre-exponential factor, e to the lambda over RT, where lambda is the heat of adsorption, absolute value of the enthalpy change, because adsorption is typically exothermic. And so I'm going to write K1 divided by K2 in terms of lambda and the temperatures. K0 doesn't change, lambda doesn't change, gas constant doesn't change, temperature's different. So K0's cancel. This is lambda over R, 1 over T1 minus 1 over T2. So now I can substitute in values. Of course, these are absolute temperatures. I can simplify this. This is exponential. And let's write it out this way to make it a little clearer, to say lambda over R, 1.263 times 10 to the minus third. So alphas, of course, cancel. This ratio left side is 6.667. And what I'm going to do, of course, that's equal to the right side. I'm going to take the log of the left side, 6.667. It's going to be equal to the log of the right side, which then becomes lambda over R times this value. So I can now solve for lambda over R. So I've done some of the calculations. I put in here units Kelvin to make sure where things come from. And so now I solve for this 12.5 kilojoules per mole. That's the heat of adsorption. Realistically, 13 kilojoules per mole. But again, I want to mention, very sensitive to these measurements. And so to get a very accurate heat of adsorption, we really would need more measurements. But the ideas would still apply.